Hello, this is Dr. Glasbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will learn how to use the gather function from the tidier package. The purpose of the gather function is to convert columns into rows. The structure of the gather function is as follows. The dataset gets piped into the function, and then you list the names of the columns that you wish to gather into rows. If you list the column names individually, then each column name needs to be separated by a comma. This is what you see in the gray code block on the left with column underscore 1, comma, column underscore 2. If all of the columns you want to gather are sequential, meaning they are all next to each other in the dataset, for example, column underscore 1, column underscore 2, and column underscore 3, then you can specify the column names as a range. This is what you see in the gray code block on the right with column underscore 1, colon, column underscore 3. After specifying the column names, there are two other inputs you need to write. The first is the key input, which is the name you will give the new column that will contain the names of the gathered columns. The second is the value input, which is the name you will give to the new column that will contain the values of the gathered columns. To illustrate how the gather function works in practice, let's now consider an example using the sample tables that are distributed as part of the tidier package. What you see here are the tables named Table 4A and Table 4B that contain a subset of data taken from the 2014 World Health Organization Global Tuberculosis Report. The tables here report the number of tuberculosis cases broken down by year and country. Table 4A contains the number of tuberculosis cases for the years 1999 and 2000 for different countries, and Table 4B contains the total population for the different countries in 1999 and 2000. Storing data in this way does not satisfy the tidy data principles, hence we would classify it as untidy. The table shown here is the tidy version of the two tables shown in the previous slide. Note that no information has been added, subtracted, or changed in the dataset. The only thing that has changed is the way the data is organized. Note that we now see separate columns for country, year, cases, and population. Our task is to figure out how to use the gather function to reshape our data from the two tables in the previous slide to the table shown on this slide. This schematic illustrates how we will use the gather function to reshape Table 4A. What we are doing here is taking the columns named 1999 and 2000 and turning them into rows. The years 1999 and 2000, instead of being column names themselves, become categories under a column named year. In the same way, the values under the 1999 and 2000 columns are all moved to a column named cases. Again, note that no information has been added, removed, or changed during this reshaping process. All we've done is organize the data into a tidy format. Here is the code that implements the reshaping process we just saw in the schematic. Let's start with Table 4A on the left. We take Table 4A and pipe it into gather. We specify the columns we wish to turn into rows, which is the range 1999:2000. Note that, since the column names 1999 and 2000 are numbers, we need to surround them with backticks so that the gather function correctly understands them to be column names. Next, we specify the input for key, which is what we want to name the column that will have the years 1999 and 2000 under it. We will name it year. Finally, we specify the input for value, which is what we want to name the column that will store the number of tuberculosis cases. We will name it cases. The gather code needed to reshape Table 4B is very similar to Table 4A. The only difference is that we've changed the value input to be equal to population instead of cases. We execute the commands and we end up with the following two tables. The reshaping worked as intended, and we are close to getting the table back to the tidy format. The last step is to merge the two tables together. This requires the use of something called a join, which finds the common categories under the country and year columns and uses them to align the data under the cases and population columns in a single table without damaging the relationships within the data. Here we show how a left join can be used to merge the tables. There are different types of joins, all of which are available as part of the dplyr package. Please note that this final step is only shown to you for the sake of completeness. Joins aren't something you've learned how to do in the course, and you are not expected to know how to do them on your own. So don't worry if you don't understand how it works. If you are curious to learn more about joins, please refer to Chapter 13 of the R for Data Science textbook.